Hello and welcome, everybody. I'm glad you made it all to this session on an alumni perspective on the bachelor's program at RSM on International Business Administration. We are both alumni of this program, and we will give you a little impression of how we experienced the program, what we've been through, what we do now, and to give you a little bit of more detailed information on what you can expect when you come to Rotterdam and study International Business Administration. There are two organizational information pieces of information that I will just pass in the beginning. There are people watching on the live stream on the internet. So also on the internet, hi and welcome to this alumni session here. If you have any questions in the meantime, come in, we just started. If you have any questions in the meantime of this presentation, just raise your hand. You can ask the question. There's one question we have for you. Just push the little button on the microphone that is in front of you. Ask your question so that everybody else on the live stream can hear this. And once you're done with the question, just push that little button again that the microphone is switched off again. Okay, well, then we get started with our presentation. And first of all, we would like to introduce ourselves. My name is Björn Zimmermann. I currently work for a German railway operator in the passenger and rail freight traffic in Europe. I work in the fields of strategy and organizational development, and I'm also the managing director of our IT company that actually provides all kinds of IT services to our group companies. And now I pass the microphone to Lisiane to continue.
Thanks. So my name is Lisiane Hel. I'm a senior consultant at IBM working in the field of talent and engagement. So basically my specialty within that field is change management. I provide large multinational organizations with support on implementations for new processes, new systems, and organizational change in general. So let's head back to where it all started, which is a little different for both of us. I grew up in a small village near Utrecht, which is in the central part of Holland, and well, did my high school there with a profile in economics and society with, well, another subject, management and organization. Especially the latter, I really, really enjoyed. The side of business, the different kinds, so not necessarily the economics part, but the wider perspective on what makes organizations thrive or not interested me. So over I went for an open day, just like all of you, here at the Erasmus University, RSM. And I found myself in an international environment already there with a lot of visitors from all over the world, which really spoke to my mind. So I applied, and in 2008, I started the IBA curriculum. Björn?
Yes. Well, the upper picture is basically describing my background. I grew up in Germany. I lived in Germany for 20 years, and then I moved to Rotterdam because I started studying IBA. For me, it was in the beginning not a really clear choice whether I wanted to do IBA. The reason why I came to Rotterdam and why I came to the Netherlands was actually because I wanted to study music. I wanted to study jazz guitar, and well, it's almost the same. but when I did the entrance exam here at Codarts at the Rotterdam Music Academy, the teacher told me, well, you know, the colors of jazz, you didn't really understood them yet. Maybe if you take two more years in practice, then it might be fine. I thought, well, I don't know whether that's really the thing I want to do. And I had applied for IBA in the meantime. And I came home, and in my mailbox, there was the letter of acceptance. And so I got into IBA, and I never regretted it. So it was a good choice that I actually did that. The funny thing today is, this is actually the second time in my life that I'm in this room. The first time that I was in this room was at the open day back in 2008 when I came here to actually get an impression of how IBA is. And back then, I had just done my A-levels in Germany, I had just finished high school, and I was doubting between the music stuff but also doing business, because it was really interesting to me. In the end, I figured out that Rotterdam was a good business school, that IBA was an interesting program. Well, and that was the way that led me here to Rotterdam, to the Erasmus Bridge in 2008.
So So yeah, our first year consisted of a lot of courses. It's really, the first year is a basic foundation, so it's the first building block of the house called IBA, or at least that's what I would like to refer it every now and then. It's a lot of generic courses that provide you with a basis for the year following onto it. So as I noticed a couple of things that I could have done better in the first year that might have provided me with more support, I decided to become a mentor in year two to support the first years with the insights that I had gained. The same counts actually for Björn, so both of us were in the mentor program, supporting the first years, getting adjusted to student life, living in the Netherlands for those from coming abroad, and actually getting used to what it is like to be a student. It's the combination of studying, but also the fun times, and finding a balance between the two might be a challenge at times, to be honest. So yeah, that's basically the second year. On the picture, you see a group of around 20 mentors that had little groups of mentees for the first couple of months and supported them well. And to be honest, we are still in touch with most of them, which is quite fun to see after having graduated from IBA 6 years ago. Time flies, I must say.
A little remark on the mentor program as well. What you could do, what I actually did, was in the first year we had mentors that actually guided us through the first year. In the second year, you could become a mentor yourself and help freshmen, first year students, to get settled in IBA in Rotterdam. And if you wanted to, you could actually continue this path and become a mentor coordinator to actually teach the mentors how to help the first year students to do that. And I did that for a good year and a half, and actually also met more mentors in the years in advance. And the funny thing is then also the friendships just really stay close, and you stay in touch, you stay in contact with all of these people that come from all over the world together here at IBA, and that all help freshman students to get settled here at RSM and to get grounded here when they start the program. Then there's the year of options. We had the second year when we were mentors, when we helped the freshman students. And at the end of the second year, you have to make a choice for yourself, because the third year of IBA starts with something you can actually choose yourself. You can choose to go on exchange to study abroad. You can choose to do an internship wherever you want, maybe somewhere in a foreign country, maybe in the Netherlands, wherever you want. And the third option is to do actually a minor. So you stay here at university and you study for one trimester something that is really outside of IBA, that is a completely different thing. So to get an impression of something that can actually be done in a different field of knowledge. What I did, you see it up here, that's train. coming back to my first statement of where I'm working right now, I decided to do an internship. I stayed in the port of Rotterdam and actually worked for 3 months at a little railway operator, and I helped to improve processes there and to develop systems. And in the end, this is still the company where I'm still working right now, and where I started my professional career, just right in the middle of my studies in my third year of IBA. You chose something different.
So, as Björn already came from Germany to the Netherlands, I was just a Dutchie in the program and wanted to experience what it would be like to study abroad. So one of the reasons I started IBA was actually the option of going on exchange. And already before starting, I said, okay, if I get the option to go on exchange and I get to go where I would like to go, it would really be Australia. So I spent half a year in Sydney at the University of New South Wales. Had a great time over there. It gave me the option to pick different courses than those that are offered here at RSM. Gave me the option to be the international for once and actually experience what it is like to live in a completely different country where I had no clue how things were arranged before actually getting there. And well, it provided me with friendships that are still here today. Everyone got there, no one knew each other. People were also just like here from all over the world, and the close-knit network started to start from day one. And I'm still in touch with people from Sydney, and well, we're hoping to go there together in a year or two to see what it is like after a couple of years. So after the year of options, which was the first trimester of IBA 3, there's still another two trimesters, which both of us passed successfully, and it brought us to the IBA graduation, which is really a graduation where you get to wear the gown and the hat and everything. And it's a really nice festivity where your family can come over, where you can actually show what you've done over the years and be proud of what you have accomplished. Anything you would like to add?
maybe not to the graduation, but that is, but is that this is actually the moment when you IBA. When we were in IBA, we had a still small program. We were about 350 students. We understood that this has grown substantially. That there are way more students in the program right now. But that was one of the moments where you could actually see everybody around. I mean, you saw people in the lectures, but people were in exchange, were doing different courses. But this was a moment when actually you yourself, but also your friends and your family you brought in could understand how IBA works, what IBA is, how diverse IBA is. There are people from all over the world. There is a close community. We talked about it just right now, that is actually a family. You know, you grow together, you know each other. It's not a big classroom where you're an anonymous individual. No, you're part of a community, and that is not just in the classroom, but that also continues afterwards in activities. If you go to a bar together, in the social activities in Rotterdam, and that was the moment when you can really understand that the world comes together there in Rotterdam. There were so many nationalities. They were all lined up to get the diploma, to receive their academic degree, and that was a moment that everybody could actually realize that. Well, that's enough to edit.
So yeah, after IBA, both of us went for a different master's degree. So that's a picture at our master graduation, because for some reason we graduated at the same day. It was a little bit of a coincidence, but it was fun for the families to also be together. I went for the master's degree in human resource management with a specialization of one of the electives in change management, because I really enjoyed the human subjects in the bachelor course. To be honest, I've never been too much of a financial person, so the financial courses for me were those that had to be done, but I enjoyed the other courses more, but that's really a personal thing. If I look at my friends, we all went different ways at that moment, so the friends also studying IBA, some went into marketing, so the marketing master's degree, others into business information management, couple of them into supply chain, and some others into the financial part. So it's a moment where you really get the chance to specialize in a way which really interests you most. There's a lot of options out there, and during the bachelor course you get little tiny bites of all of the courses already. So there is a bachelor's course in human resource management, but it's only a tiny part of what the master's degree is all about. So throughout the bachelor's, you get more and more insights in what it is that actually thrives you, what gives you energy, and then in a master's degree you get the chance to go into a direction that really fits you. So Björn chose a different master's degree than I did, but yeah, also in a field that he already was interested in because of his internship.
Exactly. I basically just followed that path that I had already started when I got into the internship in the port of Rotterdam. So for me, it was a logical consequence, a logical decision to actually pursue my master's degree in supply chain management, which is basically the whole process of logistics from producing in the factory until delivery in the shops where you can actually buy your grocery product at Albert Heijn or at a different store somewhere in the world, actually. And because the university actually worked closely together with companies in the port and also in the Netherlands, we did a lot of trips to actually visit companies, to visit factories, to understand how logistical processes work. And that was for me just the perfect combination to expand my general knowledge of international business administration with a hands-on master's program in supply chain management with a logistical background. Well, that brings us to the master graduation, and that basically is the perfect bridge to the point where you think, okay, now I'm done with my studies, I've got a nice bachelor's degree, I've got a nice master's degree, now I have to work and find a job. And what we talked about, we have a lot of friends, and we just collected all kind of companies where friends of us have started after their degrees, after graduating from university, and by now the first people have switched their jobs. So we used to have a nice picture and some of the company logos above, but now there are so many companies where friends of us, where university mates have started working, so that we actually needed the whole slide to put that up.
Yeah, so like I said, some of our friends went into different directions, others took the same master's degree, but if we look now at the companies they are working for, it's even more diverse. Where the IBA bachelor is really a generalist education, it really provides you with that house of IBA, which is just a start, and then a master's degree allows you to specialize into a certain direction. but it doesn't mean you need to go into that field of business after you have graduated. A lot of our friends actually started in traineeships, which are quite popular in organizations these days, combining really the practical experience still with educational parts and trainings on the job. Some of us went into the traineeships and ended up now as, for example, the manager of a service center. Others went into marketing and are actually doing the branding for large multinationals. Some went into supply chain management, like Björn, but also another one working really on demand planning, making sure that the stocks are actually on target and that everything is at the shops on time. Just having a look at it, some of us work as financial managers, and it's really a diverse thing, so it's up to you. With IBA as a foundation and the specialization of the master, the world is open to you, and especially with the diverse background of all the international experience you have already gained in a master's, multinationals are more than open to welcome you, I would say. So yeah.
Not only multinationals are open to you. You chose to actually work for a big organization that is a multinational, that is represented on every continent. I chose for a little family company that is situated in Germany but actually operates throughout Europe. So the scope in which organization you want to work is also really diverse. You can just really choose whatever you want. Everything is suited for you. The interesting thing about IBA is that you really get a good solid base, and you get a way of thinking. You are able to really quickly understand very different backgrounds, very different topics, things that you have never learned or heard about before. And IBA teaches you a way to understand and to individually and for yourself to work into different topics that can actually help you in all kinds of situations on the work floor. So it's not just that you get out of university and you have to get an accountant function, or you have to get a bookkeeping function or whatsoever. No, IBA lets you actually choose from a broad perspective, and you've got all kinds of options that are out there on the market. We have so many friends that work in very different businesses, companies, continents. So if you do this, you've got everything you need out there.
And that actually brings us to the last slide, which are the questions for you. So we've put in a picture of the Oude Haven in Rotterdam, which is, well, the area where a lot of cafes and restaurants are situated, where we still like to go for a drink every now and then, and where we like to talk. So we would like to open the floor for questions and talk to you, because we're curious to hear more.
What exactly is the difference between IBA and just normal business school, bedrijfskunde?
The difference between IBA and the BA program, so the business administration one, is the I at the beginning. So it's really about the international experience. The Bachelor of Business Administration is taught completely in Dutch, whereas the IBA one is taught in English. The classroom is a lot more diverse, having over 50% of international students in there. So only 50% of them will be Dutch at most, and the other part will be international. So it's really focusing on that international component. The diversity plays a larger role, and the language.
Thank you. But did it help you? Did it help you in your career that you took the international MBA, the business administration, instead of the normal one, the Dutch one?
Yeah, I would say yes, definitely. If I look back at the past week, from Monday to Wednesday, I hosted a training with 31 participants all over the world, and it just gives me that extra thing to actually work with the different cultures. It's the cultural diversity you understand, less assumptions, making sure that you actually work with people instead of assuming that everything is going the Dutch way. So it did help me from that perspective. And I would say that, yeah.
Yeah, it's. I can only add to that. When we were in school, I mean, you often get from the school books examples. For instance, you as European, you go to China and you do business there. But trust me, if you go from the Netherlands to Germany, it might be not that far away, but there's the same cultural barrier that might not be as high, but there are still all kind of things that you can get to know during your business, during your business day. And if you have this background, and if you're just aware of what could happen, you're perfectly prepared to manage all of these kind of situations. And looking at the world, how it all grows together, how there is one Europe, we are just happy that we did the I instead of the IBA to actually manage these kind of things.
And do you really think that the I gave you more, really more opportunities? Because you stayed in Holland, you stayed in Rotterdam, and now you are not anymore in Rotterdam, I think you're in Germany right now. But in the beginning, did it give you really more opportunity, the I?
Well, maybe our examples might be that the BA might have been enough, but we do have a lot of friends that actually went abroad, that actually went to work outside of Europe, outside of the Netherlands, and there they were actually favorite candidates because they had the I in it. But it's also more, I don't know whether it's only a question of application and selection processes, but it's also what can you take yourself out of that? Even if you stay in the Netherlands, you have a big advantage, not just on the job market, but also in the work you do afterwards. So we can only, from the perspective we have, advice to, if you're interested and if you're open for that and you want to have an international perspective, well, then choose IBA and don't do BA.
Okay. Hiring people,
you're welcome.
Maybe I can comment to that as well. Hiring people on an international basis for international companies, definitely having an eye in the education would be a preferential treat.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
What are the core and elective modules that you learn in this course?
So the bachelor program is really all core courses. So it's only core courses, and the third year is the only point where you have an option with a minor, the exchange, or the internship. The master's is all about the core courses and electives that are out there to choose. So you can choose electives within your own master's degree, but also electives from the other master degrees to create a more diverse perspective. Does that answer your question? Or?
I know, I actually wanted to know what it is that we learn.
Okay, so what is it that you learn? If you look at an organization, it's the strategy part that points directions out for the other functions. You have the financial part in IBA, which is corporate finance and management accounting. There's human resource management in the bachelor's program. There's foundations of mathematics and statistics, because those also get back into business. Let me think. Yeah, supply chain management, so the logistical part is also part of the bachelor program. There is innovation management, which is really focusing at today's technology, advancing. Marketing management, communication skills, cross-cultural skills. Presentation skills are also part of it. So there are some smaller courses there as well. So it's all across business. As soon as you take an organization and you look at the different departments and functions in there, it all comes across at some point during the curriculum.
I just had a question. If you get into the bachelor, are you sure that you're going to get into the master's?
Well, and then I need to look at the program management, because I think that something has changed by now. So the question was, once you get into the bachelor, is it sure that you will get into the master's degree?
If you look at the year that Björn and Lisianne graduated from IBA, it was the case. So after you finish your bachelor, you completed your bachelor, you continue to the master within RSM because you're internal students. If you look at the current situation, you look at the numbers of students applying for a certain master. And depending which master you're going to apply for, there is also some criteria or requirements for internal students. So it really depends on which master you're interested in, I would say. Yeah?
Thank you.
Do you have any friends that actually started their own company? Or?
Within our close circle of friends, they did not. But if you look at the wider community of our cohort years, so the 2008 starters, there are some people that did start their own companies, yes.
Okay, thank you.
What was the biggest challenge you had to face in your early years?
Nice choice. the biggest challenge. I do clearly not have one moment where of which I could say this was really, really tough. But I do remember that I was, and I thought it was in mentor class, we had this, there was a graph that actually says when you start something new, you know, your your happiness level goes really up. You get into Rotterdam and it's all great and it's all fantastic, and you get to here and you're in the city, you're on your own, you know, and it's a big city and you've got a lot of friends and there's a lot of cool stuff going on and your happiness goes up. And then after a couple of months, it just goes all the way down, because all of a sudden you feel lonely and you don't know what you're doing here, and then you have got exams, maybe something didn't go well, or it's just really hard because there's a lot of workload. And that was just the phase that I really remember that I thought was, what am I doing here actually? And then there's actually the point when you have IBA and you've got your courses and you have this close group of people, and you see that more people are actually working on that, and that more people actually have this problem and that are actually struggling with that. And then all of a sudden it picks up again, and then you see, I got through the exams, I got okay grades, I can move on, and then you just pass through, and once you're through that, then life is fine, because then you found your way and you know how to continue with that. So I don't know, I cannot really find one spot where I had some problems, maybe an exam that didn't go well or that it was just really busy, but that was a moment that I really remember at the end of the first year and the beginning of at the end of the first trimester, beginning of the second trimester, that I had some issues with that.
Do you have any tips and tricks to like where you pass that whole stage of your life when you have to deal with all these drastic movements and changes?
Be active, make friends, find people at university you actually really feel comfortable with, share your worries, your feelings with all kind of study mates that are in university. Make use of the mentor program. The mentors are not just there because you have to attend the sessions. Go to them, go talk to them. If you have trouble, if you have problems, if you don't know what to do, go talk to them. They are basically your communication line also to upper levels that can help you if you're in a tricky situation. But that is really something, this family character of IBA just really helps you to get through that. That is the one thing I can advise to you.
I was told that you need some kind of international experience to apply for IBA. What kind of international experience did you have?
Well, the only international experience I had was that I attended a student exchange during my high school years, and that wasn't a half-year student exchange. When you really go abroad for a long time, I just went for 2 weeks to United States because my school had a partnership with another school, and the Americans came over to visit our high school. But the good thing was that I stayed in touch with the people, and actually by the time that I had come to the point that I had to apply to IBA, I was still in touch with them, and I hadn't been there again, but we were on the internet. Facebook was just starting up and you still had MySpace and all these kind of things. So we were in touch, and that was one of the main things that I put also into my letter of application, that I said, I want to keep this contact. I want to stay in touch with people. So I didn't have this broad international experience, but I had been in contact with people, and that was the one thing that I put in. For you, it was, I thought, the same, more or less, right?
Yeah, it was more or less the same. I did a bilingual high school education here in the Netherlands, so the TTO for some of you in the room maybe, which really helped me actually get in, because I already had that, well, international focus a little more, or at least I was more aware of it at that point of time. Did a couple of exchange programs with Denmark, the UK, and Germany, and well, that was it for me.
Yeah, I just wanted to hear your views on how strong the alumni network is in terms of developing your career now. Imagine, hypothetically, no doubt you're very happy where you are, but if you were thinking of the next move, changing companies, would your first port of call be your fellow alumni? Is it a very strong international network like that, where you, instead of looking through the job pages?
Yeah, I would say it is, because I remember the first day, my first job as a consultant, so I had a client space. I walked into the office and I saw an IBA alumni there 2 years above me, and I was like, whoa, what are you doing here? And that was already the moment where I realized, after noticing someone in Berlin that also did IBA a year below us, that IBAers are all over the world. It doesn't matter where you are, at some point you will walk into them, whether it's at an airport, in an office, or just in a city. They are there, and I know that I can actually talk to them quite easily, because you have a common denominator. that makes conversations really easy. The other day, a colleague asked me, like, so can you help me a little further within my own organization? I'm looking into that and that. And I said, so what is your background? She said, well, I studied at RSM. That's an open door to actually start the conversation. The other way around, it will work exactly the same. If I know that someone has worked or has studied at RSM, it's even better if they did IBA, because then your common denominator is even bigger. But it just helps, and people are everywhere.
Ik zou eens willen weten, waarom zou je kiezen bijvoorbeeld voor Rotterdam en niet Tilburg?
So the question is, why would you opt for Rotterdam instead of Tilburg? For me, when I started looking into business administration studies or IBA studies at the time, I wanted to study in a real big city, a city that actually breathes the internationality already. And that is a factor that is there more in Rotterdam, according to my perspective, than in other cities in the Netherlands. If you look at Maastricht, for example, the largest part of the international students actually comes from Germany, whereas here, the 50% that is non-Dutch is actually from all over the world. People know Rotterdam. It's even higher in the rankings these days than it was when we started. But it is the international atmosphere that the city actually has. Whereas Amsterdam has more tourists, Rotterdam really has people that moved over here and are from all sorts of backgrounds.
Yeah, exactly. There's a minimum of 33 points to come into... sorry?
No, it's all good.
Yeah.
It's all good.
So what would you do if you think that your chance to get the 33 points is less? What would be the best choice? To still go for the numerous fixes, or you say, rather than choose for Tilburg to have more chance? What would you do? Kind of political question.
And also a tricky question, because our application procedure was really different. So, well, we cannot really reflect on that from our own experience.
Would they really look at the 33? Would you get... Because you lose your numerous fixes place.
I find it hard to judge just because our application process has been so different. And to be honest, I'm not totally aware of the current application process. But maybe. I see Shao pointing at Adri, so. Yeah?
It depends what 33 it exactly is. Because if an IBA student brings, on average, 6 straight 5s for the main courses, the difference is made up by the extended essay in the theory of knowledge. So when a student has 30 on the main courses and doesn't bring any additional credits for the extended essay in theory of knowledge, we must still consider.
That's a good answer. Thank you. Yeah.
Best to answer that.
And there was another question up there.
What are the main requirements for the IBA program? From a VVO profile from Netherlands.
There's another application question. No.
What was the question?
VVO requirements.
An average grade of 7, 7 for mathematics, 7 for English.
Quick answer.
Is that for...
Can you get a little closer to the microphone?
Sorry. Is that for mathematics A and regular English?
So mathematics B is 6 will do. Mathematics A to 7 is required.
And for IB English?
A 5. Yes.
The IBA curriculum is all about the company functions, but how about the development of your social skills? What attention is that in the program?
So, because IBA is such a close-knit community, the social skills will come hand-in-hand with it almost. Besides that, there are a couple of general skills courses, for example, the communication skills, the presentation skills. There's one in academic writing, which is a little less social, but it's also a generic skill that will come in handy at certain times. Social skills are really about making sure, same point as Björn mentioned earlier, about being out there, being active, getting in touch with people, making sure you have a support network of friends behind you, because those are the ones that can actually help you.
Maybe a little note on that as well. When I came to the Netherlands, I realized that the thing of fraternities and sororities is a really big thing in the Netherlands. I didn't know that from Germany, and I didn't know what it was all about. And I talked to people, and actually everybody said, I don't want to blame any fraternity whatsoever here, don't get me wrong. But we all didn't need to get a member of a fraternity or a sorority, because the social network of IBA is so close and you make so many friends that we actually all said, well, there's no need to actually get in somewhere. There are so many people, there are so many activities, that's enough. If you want to, there are still people who became a member of fraternity or sorority, that's all fine. But we actually said, we don't need to. There's so much going on, that's all good. There are more questions. Yes, please.
How many alumni is there? It doesn't.
How many alumni?
Yeah.
Whew. Any statistics? IBA is now 50. Sorry?
IBA is slightly over 3,000.
More than 3,000 by now. The program is now 15 years old. 17 years, obviously, yeah.
And do you know some hotshot COAs who, over here, I'm here.
Oh, there.
Do you know really some hotshot COAs who did this study? Big names? I'm working in European area, you know, and you got all kinds of charts, you see, that one did this, in law studies, in fact, so. Then big references over there. What are our reference over here? Do you know that?
We did have one another people at graduation ceremonies, also from business life, who may climbed up the ladder pretty much, but not like the really top. I don't think so, because also, I mean, 17 years in business and to really be up at the top is also a short period of time, right?
This is Rotterdam, huh?
But then we make it happen, yeah. Maybe in the port. Yeah. Okay, there we hear it. The first CFO at Royal Bank of Scotland is an IBA McKinsey. Yeah. Yeah? Okay, well, it's time, I just hear, so we have to round up. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope you enjoyed it.